Quite often what happens when an aging fighter is that what the mind wants to do and what the body is able to do are not connected. The wires have been frayed over time and they're not very well connected.
Knockout King Belly, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Live in Miami, Kara City, 305. CC Zone, KO King Belly. Everything I do is out here, come from here. You know, growing up in Kara City. It's like any other neighborhood, you know what I'm saying? We had drugs, more guns, you know? You know, everybody got to make their own decision, you know, in life when you're trying to move forward. Now it's time to fall. Motherfucker, what I hate to say. You can get it any day. I deserve it all. I've been grinding for a long time, waiting for my name to be called. Now it's time to fall. Motherfucker, what I hate to say. You can get it any day. I'm balling in the major way. My introduction to boxing just came off of me wanting to go to the gym and fight. You know, me and my friends, we would always ride by the gym on the bus, and we'd always talk about we're gonna go there, we're gonna check it out one day. And one day I was just home bushing around, and I called in and got all the information, and me and my mom was at the crib just chilling. I told her to take me up there, and we shot up there, and it was on ever since. Me and Devin Alexander? Okay, yeah, we can do that. All day. Oh yeah, tell them to send that paperwork. I'm ready to sign that already. That's a done deal. Holler back at me.
Birthday. It's your birthday.
If I die, bury me in St. Louis now.
They ask me what I do and who I do it for. Yeah. And how I come up with this shit up in the studio.
Yeah.
All I want for my birthday is a big booty hoe.
True.
All I want for my birthday is a big booty hoe. Yeah. When I die, bury me in St. Louis style. So I call him Big Booty.
Skirt, skirt.
Wrist moving, cookie getting to it.
Cookie.
I'm in the kitchen.
I'm in the kitchen.
Yams everywhere.
Damn.
Just made a jewel.
Damn.
I got bands everywhere.
Damn.
You the realest nigga breathing if I hold my breath.
Damn.
Referee with a whistle. Hold his tag. Extendo clip.
Extendo
roll.
Extendo roll.
Your girl.
Live at the Mint Lounge with dog Randall, my champ, people's champ, legendary Mint Lounge, we live.
Transition from fighting in the street and the boxing, you know, it disciplined me a lot more, you know. It kind of changed my attitude and my whole thought process as far as being out here because guns started to come into play. Fools ain't want to get their ass whooped no more. You know what I'm saying? You beat a nigga up, he gonna go get a gun. So, you know, that kind of that kind of changed too. So when I started the boxing thing, you know what I'm saying, it kind of calmed me down from fighting in the street because I knew I had the advantage already.
For this fight with Randall, we pretty much stick with the same plan. Mondays, he gets up in the morning, he runs. Then he comes to the gym around 12 o'clock. Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays are usually sparring days. So his sparring partner will be here and maybe around 2 o'clock on those days. And he might do anywhere from 8 to 12 rounds. He's born with the power. Instead of chasing guys, you just cut the ring off and you close that gap. And so he lands with punches. Lights out.
I've never been nervous for a fight. I guess that's kind of a problem. Fighting was so easy. Like, I'm dealing with guns out here. You're dealing with guns on the street. You know what I'm saying? All type of other shit. You going in the ring. Only thing you got is some gloves. I'm gonna beat your ass now. Ain't nobody gonna help you. You ain't got no gun. I ain't got to worry about you shooting me out there. It's fun, basically.
Randall became a champion, man. That's what's up, man. You did well, man. You did well.
It's all about the kids, you know what I'm saying? He just won. We got a whole flop. All our boys going to college. I got my son in college right now, up in Minnesota. K.O. Jr. I said going this fight, I know I'm gonna have to start fast with this guy, you know what I'm saying? And hurt him early. He talking all that shit about he gonna come and he gonna break my ribs and do all that. I don't think he gonna be standing in front of me trying to bang and go to the body like he that power puncher, you know? That ain't him.
Hands not the only thing you gotta worry about, but I ain't gonna tell you too much. You know what I'm saying? So just go ahead and just be aware that this boy destroyed careers because it's his time now. He's been through a lot, of been avoided, man, by the best, you know? And these guys can lie and say they haven't been avoiding him. I know the real, you know? I've been around this game a lot.
It's just a start. It's just a start, that's what's up.
954. 305, all the way live.
That's what's up.
The training part of boxing is really the hardest part, as far as, you know, being disciplined, staying home, and all the other shit that go along with it. Knockout King came back in, I want to say 99, 2000. They had me, Zab Judah, Costa Zoo, Arturo Gotti, God Bless the Dead, and Sean Bay Mitchell on the cover of KO Magazine or Ring Magazine, one of them shits. And they gave me that name. I ain't into names, but you know, as my career started to wind down, you know, I thought I had to put a little swag in it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, make my regular name a little more exciting. And Knockout King came easy. And that's what I do. I knock people out.